Hi, this is Ethan Tapper, the Chittenden County Forester, and I'm here today to demonstrate a method for controlling invasive species called a cut-stump application method. So invasive plants are a huge threat worldwide. These are exotic plants that have been introduced into the landscape and that displace our native plants. They can have a number of different harmful effects, but ultimately they disrupt the ecology of our forests by displacing our native species and by interfering with the natural growth and development processes of our forested ecosystems. And so there's a bunch of different options for removing them. I won't demonstrate all of them here. One method, depending on the number of plants and the amount of time and energy you have to devote to invasive plant control, is just pulling those plants up. So if it's just a few plants, or if you have a lot of time and energy, you can go and pull the plants up. I would say pull up as much of the plant as you can. So any root fragment you leave in the soil is going to sprout and become a new plant. So what I would do is dig up the plant, get as much of the root system out as you can, and then hang some flagging or something like that from a tree, so you can revisit that site, because every little piece of root fragment will resprout and you'll have to pull that up again. On a large scale, dozens of acres or a very, very dense infestation, it may not be feasible to use a mechanical treatment method like pulling the plants up to kill a species. It would just take so much time and so much energy, and you'd have to return to the site again and again and again and again, that it would probably just not lead to those species actually being controlled. And so this is a context in which we can use herbicide in a very limited, targeted, and thoughtful way to expand our capacity and actually allow us to address invasive species infestations across our landscape. So what it will do is turn your visit to that plant from something that you have to repeat again and again and again in order to control it, to being a one-time visit, you kill the plant, and that's it. I have gone from a place of being very skeptical of the role of herbicides in ecosystem restoration to being someone who encourages people to use herbicide in very specific and limited ways, because I understand that it will be a part of how we address invasive exotic plant infestations across our landscape. So here's a couple caveats. With any herbicide, the label on the herbicide is the law. So there will be a booklet that's attached to the front of that container of herbicide, which will tell you when it's appropriate to apply, how much you should apply, the appropriate personal protective equipment that you should be wearing, etc. And that is the law, so you have to follow that. You are allowed to apply some herbicides on your own land, and you can buy some herbicides over the counter. So these are thought to be, in general, less harmful herbicides. And the herbicide that I would always recommend is glyphosate. So you can buy glyphosate concentrate that's usually 40% active ingredient glyphosate in many different places. I see it most commonly at Tractor Supply and at Agway. And the glyphosate is the chemical that we want to use, because it is, by all accounts, by far the most environmentally benign herbicide that we have access to. It breaks down very quickly in the soil. It bonds strongly to soil particles so that it's not leaching into groundwater. And it doesn't have any soil activity. So once it gets into the soil, whether it's in, you know, in the tissue of a plant or something like that, it's not gonna harm other plants through the soil. So that's usually the herbicide that I ask people to use. And for the best way to do this, if you're able to, is using what's called a cut-stump application method. So this is the most targeted and the most minimal herbicide application method that you can possibly use. And in that, I use a tool called a Buckthorn Blaster. So this is a tool that is, it's a modified bingo dauber. You can get it on the internet for $6, and it's 4 ounces. And what I do is I fill it halfway up, so 2 ounces of 40% active ingredient glyphosate concentrate, 2 ounces of water, and then I add a blue dye, I add a turf dye. You can also probably use a food coloring. The only purpose of the dye is so that you can see the plants that you've already treated. And you'll see that this, on the tip of it is a sponge. So it doesn't leak, it doesn't get on you. It's this incredibly safe and minimal way to apply. And this 4 ounce container is enough herbicide to treat hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of plants. And so behind me I have a honeysuckle, and I'm gonna demonstrate how this works. So I use a little folding Silky brand handsaw, or I'll use a pair of loppers like this. So all I'm doing is just cutting every stem of this multi-stemmed honeysuckle. And then I take my Buckthorn Blaster. And I'm just dabbing it on the surface of that cut stump. So now what will happen is that the amount of herbicide, and this is several drops of herbicide for this entire plant, will get translocated throughout the plant. Instead of resprouting, it will just kill the plant. And then I won't have to come back here again and visit it. So by using herbicide, what we can do is sort of more realistically address invasive exotic plant infestations on our landscape at a scale that is not simply feasible with mechanical operations. And so in this way, I think that developing a nuanced relationship with these chemicals and how they can be used actually for good is a really important part of how we are going to deal with invasive plant problems in general.